Good morning, class, and welcome to the American Hypnosis Association presentation of Hypnosis and Mommy and Me. My name is Lisa Mackenberg, and I'm a staff hypnotherapist and instructor at the Hypnosis Motivation Institute in Tarzana, California. I'm also the facilitator of the Infant and Toddler Program at Gone Malibu in Malibu, California. And I welcome you all today. Thank you. The name of our class is Hypnosis and Parenting, How to Hypnotize Your Baby to Sleep Through the Night. And you might say, especially you might be saying, but Lisa, my baby's only 2 months old. How could I possibly hypnotize my baby? And the answer is, you're doing it already, and I can prove it. Especially with this little guy over here. How many people in this class have ever caught the eye of their baby 12 weeks or older and given your baby a great big smile? What does your baby do? He or she immediately smiles back. That is hypnosis. That is your baby being suggestible to you. And a matter of fact, your baby's so suggestible to you, when you smile at baby, he or she smiles back. It even has a name. That's called the smile reflex, because your baby is suggestible to you. When you smile, he or she smiles back. Imagine, class, using that power for you to hypnotize baby to sleep through the night. But before we get into our lecture, I think we should start with a song. And here we go. If you're happy, everybody has to sing, this is not a solo. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, and your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray, hooray! If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray, hooray! If you're happy and you know it, and your face will surely show it. If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray, hooray! Yay! Well, I would like to introduce my wonderful teaching assistants, Pani Way. And we have Romy Marcus.
Hello.
And before we start our lecture, Pani and Romy are going to hand out snacks to mommies and babies, and then we'll get to the heart of our class, which is how to hypnotize your baby to sleep through the night. Even you, Charlie, especially you. So as we're handing out the snacks, now that you know who I am, I want to find out who you are. We're going to start right here with this mommy. What's your name?
Angie.
Can you introduce your babies?
This is Ella.
Yes.
And this is Emma.
Hi, Emma. Hi, Ella.
Hi, I'm Shauna.
And this is Noah.
Welcome, Shauna and Noah.
I'm Jessie, and this is Rylan.
Welcome.
Emma, come on.
Oh, Riley and Jessie.
Rylan.
Rylan and Jessie. And welcome.
I'm Sari. And this is Nehoai.
Welcome, Sari and Nehoai. And?
I'm Hanani, I'm your right father.
Welcome, Hanani. And how about over here?
I'm Ivy, and this is Eli.
Welcome, Ivy and Eli.
And I'm Chelsea, and this is Charlie.
Welcome, Chelsea and Charlie. And who's our friend over here? And who's our friend over here? Go ahead and introduce yourself. You're Dolores, and you have Emma sitting on your lap. Great. Well, let's get our snacks. And it's all right, babies and mommies can walk all over. Hypnosis to help babies sleep through the night. Well, first of all, hypnosis and sleep are intricately related. As a matter of fact, did you know everybody in this room and everybody watching has been in hypnosis at least twice in 24 hours? It's true. Hypnosis is the last conscious state between waking and sleeping and waking. And that lovely, daydreamy, light, heavy, conscious, floaty feeling, you are in a state of hyper-learning or hyper-suggestibility. So hypnosis for sleep is a natural partnership. So here, I'm going to tell you what the American Hypnosis the American Academy of Pediatric Medicine says about sleep. All sleep is association, and all hypnosis is association. Hanani, when you think about of a golden watch going back and forth, what do you think of? You think of what?
The golden watch.
The golden watch. What do you think of when you see the golden watch, Romy? Hypnosis. What do you think of with the golden watch? It's the association. Now, all sleep is association. Also, it's a law of sleep. It's a law of association. It's a law of hypnosis. So now I'm going to ask Romy. I will prove all sleep is association. All sleep is association. Hey, Romy, if I took you out of your nice, warm, comfy bed, and I put you in the middle of Fresno on the floor at a motel with no pillow and a sign, neon sign outside the door that said, vacancy, 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 how would you sleep the first night?
Not so good.
How would you all sleep the first night?
Not so good.
Not so good, because it's not your association. But if I forced you to sleep there 21 nights in a row, how do you think you'd sleep after about the fourth or fifth night?
Really well.
What do you think?
Excellent.
And then after 21 nights, if I put you in your nice, soft, warm, comfy bed with the lights off, how would you sleep, Romy?
Not so good.
How would you sleep?
Not very good.
Because the association is on the floor with no pillow, vacancy, vacancy. So now we know all sleep is association. The American Academy of Pediatric Medicine says, for you to have babies sleep through the night, you need to set up sleep associations. And that means a routine, the same routine every night. Now, let's add in some hypnosis. Remember how baby is suggestible to you? Part of your sleep association should be reading a story, yes? Have a sleep book with pictures of everybody in your family sleeping in his or her own bed, including your baby sleeping in his or her own bed, so he or she gets the association, and here's mine. Why, we had a very busy day. We all went to the beach with Daddy. And we jumped in the sand. And now it's time for bed. So we have our snack. And we get into our pajamas. Now, don't forget, this is all your family. Babies love looking at pictures of themselves and of you. And then we read a story. We read a story. And we read a story to our pets. And baby sleeps in his own cradle or her own cradle. Brother sleeps in his own bed. And brother sleeps with a kitty in his own bed. And you sleep in your own bed. Now, how do you think your child would like seeing a picture of him or her asleep in his or her own sleep space? You like that?
Yeah.
So that would be your sleep book. Make your sleep book. All right? Now, how do we use hypnosis? Now, did you know the research shows that the way that you put your baby to sleep is the way your baby will go back to sleep? Sarit, Ivy, if you nurse baby to sleep, if he or she wakes up in the middle of the night, you're going to have to nurse baby to go back to sleep. What do you think of that? Everybody know that? If you rock baby to sleep and baby wakes up in the middle of the night, what are you going to need to do? Rock baby back to sleep. So we want to put baby in the sleep space, drowsy but awake. Go ahead and nurse until baby falls asleep, but then tickle the toes until he or she is drowsy but awake, and put baby down in the sleep space with this hypnosis. Are you ready, Angie? We are going to use hypnosis because when baby's between waking and sleeping, he or she is very suggestible, so we use the following hypnosis. And the words aren't important, just get the idea. You will sleep quickly, calmly, and deeply. all through the night, sleeping so deeply and calmly. If you wake up, merely close your eyes and go back to sleep, because you know mommy loves you and daddy loves you, and you will wake up when the sun comes up. Now, your baby doesn't know what to do if he or she wakes up. They don't know what to do. They've only been living on the earth for 15 months. So listen to this, guys. Did you know that everybody here wakes up sometimes in the middle of the night? You might not know because you don't remember, right? Because you merely close your eyes and go back to sleep, right, Shauna? We need to teach baby that, so let's listen. You will sleep quickly, calmly, soundly, and deeply all through the night. If you wake up, you will merely close your eyes, get that sleepy feeling, and close your eyes and go right back to sleep, sleeping till the sun comes up in the morning. And that's our hypnosis. But I know what you're all thinking. You're all thinking, well, that's good for the first time. The baby wakes up in the middle of the night, and that's good for the second time. But by the sixth time, I'm exhausted, and I just put baby in bed with me. Who thought that? Is that okay with you? If it's okay with you, it's okay with me. But who would rather baby sleep in his or own space? Anybody? Okay. Now, baby has made the association, if I scream long enough and hard enough, my mommy and my daddy will put me in bed with him and her. Baby knows that. So why would you stop? But by the sixth or seventh time, you're exhausted, am I right? Especially if you're working, have other children. So what we need now is self-hypnosis so that we can teach baby how to sleep in his or her own space all through the night. It's all right, Dolores, she can get it, it's all right. She can go, it's fine. So we need to learn self-hypnosis. Does anybody get agitated by the sixth or seventh or eighth or ninth time? Anyone get upset when it happens? All right, anybody? Yeah, okay. So now we need hypnosis, self-hypnosis, to be calm. Do you know why? Did you know, remember the smile reflex? Who remembers the smile reflex? When you catch baby's eye and go like this, does baby smile back? Mm-hmm. Baby is a magnifying glass of your emotion. So if you start to get agitated, what does baby magnify? A feeling of being what? Agitated. If you get upset, baby magnifies a feeling of being what? Upset.